misses the ball, so it's second and 10, Green. And here they are in motion again, and trip formation. They run the fullback draw. Pretty good defense. One back set in the backfield. Washington, a 3-yard gain. It's 3rd and 7 from the Arizona 35. 3rd and 7. They throw the ball, and it's overthrown. They call a penalty right here on it. Now, I understand this was the Pac-10 official. Did you think that was a good call? Was that a fact?
Questionable.
Here they hand the ball to fullback. That's what the wishbone does to you. Here we're throwing the ball, come out throwing, and all of a sudden they hand the ball to fullback and you make yardage. Now they hand the ball in like a backside cut, poor tackling. Kevin Thompson makes a play. The safety, 22, makes a big play later on in the game. Hand the ball to fullback again. The linebackers make the play. Casper Blevins, along with their front there. 3rd and 2 from the 31. They run the fullback again, hand it off, and
Mario Hampton on the carry.
Get the ball. Penalty killed us. On a 3rd down play, they throw incomplete, and we should have them punting to it. But they run the option play and get stretched. Adrian Cooper makes the play, 43.
Tackled by number 43.
2nd and 6, Adrian Cooper. From the Oklahoma 24. First drive of the ball game. Double slot, put the motion. They run the fullback. They can run a triple option off that. Good defensive play. Blevins, the linebacker, makes the play. Casper, another big play here. 3rd and 3 from the 21. Motion out of wide slot. Here's a good play by Adrian Cooper. Blevins got Evans in pursuit. 4th and 3, so they kick the field goal. Faff on, due to an injury to their top kicker, and he knocks it in. It's good. Arizona leads on the opening drive, 3-0. Beautiful field. I tell you, this field we have, the super turf, is a great wet field. We just painted our field last week, so you can see the new first home game. We fumbled the ball. We're fortunate to get the ball back right here.
Rod Fisher.
That's his first carry on kickoff return. He loses the ball. You got to hold on the ball, Rod. All right, here we go. Option play, first down. Could have pitched the ball, and I think we'd had a play right there. Jamel got slow play, so he jumps up and gets 2 yards. 2nd and 8 at the Oklahoma 20. Ball was wet. Here's Jamel Holloway. Pitched the ball to Damon Stell. Hit the tractor for first down. Ball up to around the 35, 37-yard line. Damon gained 16 on the play. A 1st and 10 now from the Oklahoma 36.
Good job to Stafford
in slow plan. Catch the ball. Look at your hands all the way, Damon. Protect the ball. 1st and 10 from the 36. Hand the ball off on a power play. Guard's supposed to be in front of the halfback. Halfback was in front of the guard. Pick up of 7, 2nd and 3. 2 splits, wishbone. Pitch the ball on the option play. I thought he made the first. That's a pretty good mark. He got close. That's about an inch away. This is a good drive. 2 tights. We had some bust on this drive, though. Just because of young offensive line, it made some mistakes here. 3rd and 1, they move the chains, though. 1st and 10 from the 48. Option play, great block going. Anthony Stafford, Jamel Holloway looks like he's well there, doesn't he? Great run by Holloway. We'll see it again. Jamel picks up 15 on this big play. Excellent day, and I think you expected him to have a big day after his confidence was built up at Carolina. I thought this track would help him. I was really worried about the great block here. Mark Van Kersbilt, come on, Stafford up in front of him. Super job there, Cavanaugh. Big game, 1st and 10. Cavanaugh, Ross is a good blocker as well, isn't he, split in? Good receiver, good blocker. Option play, we had a bust here. And we take a loss. We got to overcome this. 2nd and 13.
Lost yardage plays
from the 45. Counter pass hit Perry, good receiver.
Now, Coach, we haven't seen this so much in the playbook. Is that because Leon Perry has much better hands than you've had in the past?
He's a good receiver, and we can put him in the flat, throw the football to him.
Let's look at this one.
Three out. Fullback. Counter action. We fake the counter draw. Counter trap to our halfback. Throw to Leon in the flat. Good hands, good receiver. Breaks that tackle. 225-pound back from Orlando, Florida. Takes it down the boundary for a big first down. Gain of 21. It's a 1st and 10 now down at the Arizona 24-yard line. Tight end in the boundary. Run a counter play. Stafford hits through the crack. Safety makes a play inside the 20. Hammerschmidt on the tackle, a converted quarterback for Arizona. Fumbled the football. Now, this is what the official said. I thought maybe they got some home cooking here. But the official said Jamel had it, turned loose of it. And so Jamel turned. Here's a good play to Jamel right there. Stafford takes the ball inside the 5. People don't know how hard that is. But that is great quick hands and recognition. Here's the option play. Touchdown, Jamel Holloway. The automatic here. No, he didn't get this one. I thought that was a touchdown play.
But was this an automatic?
Yeah, he automatic. He does a lot of things at the line of scrimmage. He has great awareness. We're unbalanced line through the field here. We run a power play. This is a heck of a run, but the Gaddis here just powers the ball down to the 1 foot line. He tried to stick it over. A gain of 7 down to the 1 yard line, second and goal from the 1. Leon Perry, fullback, touchdown. We'll see that one again. Of course, one of the big plays was Holloway around the left side for 7 when it was 4th and 1 from the 15. The big Leon goes across from the 1 yard line for Oklahoma's first touchdown of the afternoon. Here it is again, Coach. Leon, fullback spin play, and he puts it in there. 14 plays, 82 yards. Oklahoma takes the lead 7-3 after R.D. Lasher makes the extra point good. First possession at home. That's a pretty good start. Todd Thompson had a good day. He kicks off into the end zone, and actually, Arizona is an excellent kicking team, Coach, but you all definitely won the kicking game yesterday.
Well, our statistics in punting weren't like theirs. We got the big kick at the end of the ball game when we needed field position, but they fumbled the punt. We fumbled the kickoff. They nearly got. There's an interception right there, and we get a 1st and 25 because the Pac-10 official calls punting right there. And the kids are emotional. I know kids jump up, they're emotional. And all of a sudden, he calls the flags as taunting after he intercepted
it. Wasn't on Parks. It was on, called one of our players. One of our players, Kenny McMitchell, was talking to Parks.
It was McMitchell, okay.
Saying something to his own player about way to go or something comes running up here. And he says it calls this taunting. But he was speaking to our guy, and they call a flag. It's a dead ball foul. So we got a 1st and 25 from the 35-yard line. You know, it's hard to overcome. That's where Mitchell gets knocked out of the ball game. They hit him up, ramp him up around the head. That should have been a 15-yard penalty there and even things out. But Jamail back to throw. Timing was going off a little on that one. Holloway's pass intended for Bross, incomplete. 3rd and a long 20. Jamail's going to scramble here. How is Mitchell, Coach?
He got his bell rung yesterday. The trainer said first not to put him back in. He was hurt on that shot right there. He carried the ball at 1 time for 7 yards and got knocked out.
This was not one of Thompson's better punts. Only 35 yards, a 6-yard return. And that's the end of the first quarter. Oklahoma's ahead, 7-3. We'll have second quarter action in a moment. We pick it up, second quarter action. Now 7-3, Oklahoma in the lead. 4th and 3 from the Arizona 37. Holly back to punt to Thompson for Oklahoma.
Here we have Charles Thompson to return the punt, second team quarterback, and pretty good return, gets the ball back to about 34-yard line. Point out, Dean, the first quarter, they actually had one possession, we had one possession, the quarter's over. That's what wishbone teams do. They control the clock and the board and the ball, and therefore the team has many opportunities with the football. You've got to do something with it when you have it. Here's Charles Thompson taking a good shot right there from the safety. Good tackle. Thompson option right. Hammerschmidt hits him. It's 3rd now and 12 from the Oklahoma 32.
Draw play.
Did we have a penalty?
Yeah,
I had a penalty there.
And we had 8
personal
penalties.
Foul on Oklahoma. Thompson takes a 2nd big hit in a row. Here we go, Charles Thompson.
Holloway in for Thompson, Coach.
4th and 7 from the Oklahoma 37.
Good throw right there. Fullback in the flat again, Perry, for first down.
Hand the ball off on trap play. We got Thompson shook up there.
Leon Perry with the ball.
Leon Perry
game
fullback.
Three.
And the ball, Gaddis bounces outside because it stopped up, and he runs for about 2 or 3 here.
Gaddis didn't have a lot of holes.
No, they ran pretty good. I tell you, Arizona can run pretty good on defense, pretty quick.
It's 3rd and 4 there from the 48. Perry up the middle, gains only 1. So that makes it 4th and 3, and a big play here from the 47 as Todd Thompson is back to punt for Oklahoma.
Big play. Kicking game. Greg Williams recovers it, our center. A lot of red shirts down there. We get the ball. Great field position here.
Quasi around there as well. We'll take another look at it. And we mentioned off the top that Oklahoma beat a very good kicking team in Arizona yesterday. You had to be pleased with that. And Todd Thompson came away from the game, maybe, Coach, with one of his better outings.
Todd hit the ball, I think, 37-yard average? Kicked the ball well off in the end zone. Kicked it well off kickoff. But you need a better average than what we have in the punting. But he did hit one big long punt to end the ball game that swapped ends of the field. Replay, big play in the kicking game.
1st and 7 from the Arizona 7. Jamail Holloway, the Oklahoma quarterback.
Loss of six. Two tights, wishbone, option play, hand the ball to fullback. First read, and that's Rodney Anderson. Good tough run. In the fourth quarter, Rodney had brought us off the goal line with some good runs. Rodney didn't want to let go of that one. Jamel Holloway, touchdown senior. Looked well there, didn't he? Option play. Maybe the best cut so far since his surgery, coach. It was third and five from the Arizona 5. Holloway sticks it in the end zone. We'll take a look at it once again as Oklahoma takes the lead 13-3 at this point. Taking advantage of the turnover. Holloway options left. Let's look at it again, coach. We have tackles on the pinch, hard stunt. Stafford lead me. And Jamel can cut pretty good right there. Explodes in the end zone. Oklahoma takes advantage of the turnover. Only three plays, going only 7 yards. Sooners lead 14-3 after this RD last year conversion. 9:13 remaining in the half at this point. Arizona still has not had the football very much, and the fourth kickoff of the ball game coming up with Todd Thompson.
We had the ball 16 minutes first half. They only had 13 minutes the first half.
You almost get another one here, coach.
Yep.
Greathouse fumbles. Wilson recovers.
Tackled by number 24.
Waters back to throw back. Good pass rush right there. Adrian Cooper, sophomore defensive end. Curtis Williams, 93 in the game. Turn protection. Try a throwback pattern here.
He doesn't have the speed, coach, but he certainly has the range and had a good ball game yesterday.
He's big. He's about 6'6", 240, but he doesn't have the Troy Johnson speed. He runs about like Darryl Reed did. Doesn't have Darryl's savvy yet. Caspering coverage. They hit the guy in the hands, and he drops it.
Makes it 3rd and 15.
Trips from the cross motion. 20. Sprint out. It's a long way to go. Casper. Good play, Casper. Blevins. 12, Kenny McMitchell.
Gain of 9, but it's still 4th and 6.
Gotta make them punt. I don't know why they didn't let that ball bounce. He catches it on the bounce, and it could have rolled the other length of the field.
Charles Thompson back in for the
Sooners. There's Fisher protecting the ball. Good job of running. Rod Fisher. Charles Thompson right here. This is it, Charlie. No, that's not the one. That's 7 steam on. Hand the ball to fullback. Got a first down.
3rd and 2. Perry makes 4. Move the chain.
Bootleg. Going up the field. Cut in. You got him going one way. Cut use your speed and cut back inside that guy. He might have scored. Just ricochet up through there, Charles. Try to be a juker. And the ball to fullback. That's a good play right there. Leon Perry.
Perry gains 7 after Thompson's 2. It's 3rd and 1 from the 45.
We have a situation right there. Shouldn't happen, but I think we end up 4th, and we're going to punt the football. We're not going to give a chance to play the percentages. Why give them field position to go score? You got a 14-3 lead. You take the halftime.
Heard a smattering of boos, but you didn't even consider going for that.
Because I know they don't know what they're talking about, you know?
All right, 1st and 10.
Let me ask you this. If we had given this field position, it had been a touchdown, right? The guy's in the end zone.
Hey, I wasn't booing.
See, that play right there, if the field position they'd had, if we hadn't made on 4th down, that'd have been a touchdown. He ran 48 yards.
McGill goes 48 down to the Oklahoma 32-yard line. We pick it up 1st and 15 now from the 37 after a procedure penalty.
Didn't want to give him field position. Make him earn it. He already earned 50 of it. Two plays.
10-yard gain.
Tried it again. Old Scotty Evans didn't fall for it. He got him.
Evans did a good job all afternoon of putting pressure on the quarterbacks of Arizona. We'll take a look at that one again. It was 2nd and 5 from the Oklahoma 27.
Good play, Scotty.
He's up 3rd down and 6.
Edmund, Oklahoma graduate. 3rd and 6 from the 28. Waters to pass again.
That ball hit the ground. I had great, of course, he couldn't see it. The headlinesman, line judge could not see that, but that ball was not complete. Hand the ball to fullback. See what happens. They play pass, and all of a sudden hand the ball to fullback. And pops through there.
Gain of 12, 1st and 10.
Waters on the carry.
Waters options right, gains four. Cooper and Blevins on the stop. Second and five. Fumble the football and he got it back. Curtis Williams makes the play. A loss of two. We'll take another look at this one, Coach. Good job, Curtis Williams. Saw the fumble. Third and seven now at the Oklahoma 7. It is 14-3. Come on, Scott Evans. Come on, Scott Evans. Get him, Scott. Good job fighting to get the ball. Adrian Cooper, Scott Evans. A loss of three. Evans isn't a large defensive tackle, but certainly has a lot of quickness, and you're pleased with him, aren't you, Coach?
Yeah, he's a good player. He's 255. He can run with good quickness, good speed, plays leverage. He plays low. He's not big, but he's hard to block because he gets underneath people's pads.
And Arizona now has a chance to at least put three on the board. It's fourth and 10 from the Oklahoma 10. The reserve kicker, Pfaff, comes on to attempt a 27-yard field goal. And this one is no good. It's wide to the right. Only 30 seconds remain. Oklahoma downs the ball, and it's halftime. Oklahoma continues to lead by the count of 14-3. In a moment, we'll give you the results of last week's Sooner Survey question. Welcome back to Oklahoma Football. I'm Dean Blevins with Coach Switzer. And, Coach, you're up 14-3 at halftime, but still I think the players probably are aware now that this is an Arizona team that is for real and they have to come out in the second half and play well.
Well, we've had four possessions, and we've had two of them we had to start with penalties. One, first and 25, you don't expect to overcome that. And we had a big break in the kicking game. We earned one. We took a long touchdown. We drove, 82 yards for one touchdown. Then we had the big play in the kicking game. We were able to get 14 points on the board, and you don't feel like you're really in control of the ball game. I got to believe Arizona thinks at the halftime they can win the football game, and they should feel that way. Dick Tomey said that his football team really looked forward to playing this game, felt like that they were up, probably as good mentally preparation to play this game as any team that they've played, because it's who we were and the respect that Oklahoma draws. So it's like I told our football team, we don't ever get to slip up on anybody. Everybody knows who we are and what we represent, and we have to be prepared to play every time. And we needed a tough game. I needed to see what type of football team we would be in the second half.
Unusual offense that Arizona employed. The wish and shoot is what they called it, a combination of the wishbone and the run and shoot. And in the second half, they had some success.
Well, I tell you what, I thought in the second half we played pretty good defense except for two plays. And our defense ends up controlling the ball game, winning the ball game for us the way they played in critical situations.
Coach, last week we had our Sooner survey question was in regards to the institution of instant replay. We asked you if you thought in college football that we should institute instant replay, and believe it or not, 80% of the viewers that called in said they thought that we should.
I thought that that would probably be somewhere the correct percentage.
And what do you
think?
Well,
I would like to have it too, but the electronic media is not going to be available at every football game. We play half of our football games not televised, or more than half are not televised. So how do you do it? Only on games that you have the media there, the electronic media televising the ball game? I think it'd be very difficult and very expensive to do it for every ball game.
All right, but you had the one call you said you think should have been reversed.
Well, I think there's no question the camera angle would, I don't know, you have to have the camera on the right angle.
Yeah.
But from my vantage point, the ball wasn't caught. It hit the ground and bounced up to him.
All right, this week's question pertains to artificial turf versus the natural surface. Of course, Oklahoma playing at USC this weekend, so give us a call if you think the Sooners perform better on an artificial surface than on natural turf. Call us at 1-900-300-6351. And if you think the Sooners perform better on the natural turf, call 1-900-300-6352.
That should be 100% next week.
You think so? 1-900-300-6351. If you think the Sooners perform better on the artificial surface, 1-900-300-6352 if your answer is no. 75 cents per call. We'll be back with third quarter action in just a moment.
Welcome back to Oklahoma football. The Sooners leading at halftime 14-3. We pick up third quarter action as Arizona kicks off to Oklahoma.
We have deferred, and as our option in the second half, we want to receive the football, leading 14-3, and we take the ball in the end zone. Mike Gaddis catches it, and he's down it. Start up first and 10, middle of the field, 20-yard line. Hand the ball off on a power play. Pick up 5 yards. Second and five, Anthony Stafford. Unbalanced line. Hand the ball off on a power play again. Not much there, so we go third and two.
Anthony Stafford again with the ball.
Physical football team, Arizona. Will run, hit you. Option play, Jamel Holloway hits a crack. That's really a good run for a first down. Third and two, move the chains. Oklahoma now first and 10 from the 35. God, trap option. Stafford's so quick. Makes something out of nothing. He had a bust in the back in a line of scrimmage in a trap option. Hand the ball off in the outside option to Leon Perry for about seven yards. Third and one from the 44. Big down. You got to win these. Third and one. Hand the ball off. Didn't hand it off. Jamail's going to keep for the first. Good strong run. First and 10 now from the 45. Fumble the football. Lucky to get it back. I don't think we get the ball back. They get it.
They get this one. How much of the problem was that Mike Wise is a new center, and how much of the problem was that the ball was
that's
wet?
That's some problem. The ball was wet, too, because we changed his pants. Jamail said the bottom of his pants were so wet, he was having a problem with it. And I noticed he fumbled a couple times bringing it out. So we had him change pants on the sidelines, have some dry pants put on. Motion, trip set, three-out pattern. And here he hits him on the boundary right there. First and 10. Arizona has success with this play. It was third and three before that. Now it's first and 10 from the Sooner 26. Remember, we gave him the ball inside our 50-yard line. You cannot do that. Here we go again. They throw it out in the flat. They're at the 20, inside the 20. Their philosophy, coach, is to stretch the defense, and they did a good job in the second half. They do that, but lining up the way they do. Then they run the option play. Here's a good play right there, but Jerry Parks, 8. He's a good player. Gain of 6. Freshman in Texas, Willow Ridge. And they missed tackle right there. Missed tackle. 3 missed tackles. He just spins around until he gets in the end zone. Hampton in for the touchdown. On a second and 4 carry, there's 9:59 remaining in the third quarter. Pfaff comes on and converts the extra point. Now the score, Oklahoma 14, Arizona 10. It's a 6-play drive, and they went 45 yards. We gave them some plus field position, and they scored. They gave us some plus field position the first half. We scored with it. And we have a clip right here. Instead of having the ball up close to 20, look where we are. Look at the field position we have. Hand the ball to the fullback. 2 yards, yard.
Talk a lot about momentum. At this point, coach, it seems like it has swung Arizona's
got
way.
Got to move the football. It's Gaddis about 7 yards. Jamel Holloway is going to make a big play. Third and two. Jamel Holloway. Option play. Good job of Mark Van Kersbilt. Good job of running Jamel. Open field. Looks well there, then. You know, coach, some other players might have broken that one all the way when they got into open field, but not
would
many
they ever got there.
But would get there. But
they might not ever get there, doesn't
it? It really does. And I tell you what, his ability to jump around this, and good job of Mark Van Kersbilt. He gets two of them. A good job, our halfback right there, Gaddis, missed tackle. In an open field situation. That's the backside corner. Catches him, knocks him out of bounds.
Pickup of 34 down to the Arizona 45 now, first and 10.
Here's Gaddis, good play with our linebacker. Salem on the stop, a pickup of 2. Second and 8 now from the 43. Hey, how about this one? Stand in there, happy feet. Touchdown, Sooners, post route. Got to do that more. We got to do that more. We just got to take shots at it and live with it. We got to make people back up. Safety, get out of there.
Eric Bross on the reception, a 43-yard touchdown, and an excellent job, coach, by Holloway of waiting and holding the ball until Bross breaks clear a little bit later than you think.
Come on, Perry, get him in the hole the first time. Perry recovers and keeps him off the mail. That was key for us to be able to throw this.
Better thrower this year, isn't he?
Yeah, he's thrown the ball well, and that guy's caught it well. Runs pretty good.
Lasher comes on for the extra point.
And it is good. Oklahoma now takes the lead 21-10, a five-play drive, 87 yards. You know, Holloway says he worked out with Rodney Pete, whom he will meet this week this summer, or will meet this week. He worked out with him this summer. Says they drew a lot this summer together.
Right. He told me that they he worked out SC with all their athletes. Knocked the ball away, gang. Oh, boy, it's a good hit. Woo! The guy caught it in midair. Donnie Smitherman, a halfback, knocked that ball out, and the ball went right near the guy caught it. They're going to throw the football. It's got to be our game right now. They're going to hit the wheel route on us, too. I saw it coming, too. The guy was sitting in the backfield. Dump pass.
Waters pass complete. David Eldridge.
Eldridge picks it up. They spread you in and pick on you. There's a good play, Scott Evans. Don't run it his way. That trip set. They go to the tight end side, one receiver side. Garl in coverage.
Pass intended for number 7, Melvin Smith.
Incomplete. Makes it 3rd and 8 from the 48. Boy, that's a good hit there, Kenny McMitchell.
One of your young secondary players, Coach, but overall, it looked like they played well yesterday.
Did. They played good. He makes some big plays in the game. We'll see one later on here. They got to punt the football. And we fake fair catch, and we let the ball get in the end zone, and we get it back out to 20. We got to do something with it. Boy, good stick right there, linebacker.
Second.
We get 2 yards. Counter play, nothing there.
Gaddis can run two twice, so that makes it 3rd and 6 from the 24. After a timeout, Oklahoma has it 3rd and 6.
Boy, it's a good job of throwing the football, catching it, Carl. Cabinets.
Pass complete to number 83.
You want to go 4 for 8 yesterday and look like a good wishbone throwing football team.
You bet. There we
go. Mike Gaddis with the ball.
Counter play. Good job of blocking right there. Charles Thompson, look out. Bang.
Charles Thompson on the carry.
KO kid right here. Second and 14. He's going to be all right. But anytime you have a back injury, and Charles said it was his back, you bring the stretcher out and you carry him off. If you have a back or a neck injury, that's just the standard procedure. You have to. And we delayed the game for several minutes here to get our stretcher out there and carry Charles off. And hopefully he's going to be all right. The trainer came to me and said that they took x-rays, and before the game was over, I had a report that they felt like he was okay. There's nothing major. It was just going to have to see how he comes along this week.
3rd and 5 from the Oklahoma 43, Holloway back in.
Little Fisher. Magic. Fisher on the option play.
He
just
can
press it so far, but I tell you what, he's got an uncanny ability to take it to the limit. Right there, draw play for nothing.
Actually loses a couple, 2nd and 12 from the 48 this time.
Fumble the football. Not playing very good. Not playing very good. Lost yardage play and the fumble the next play. Look where they get the ball. They get the ball midfield. They don't have to go 50 yards to score. First possession, second at the third quarter, Dean, they had only 45 yards to go score. Now they only got 50 yards to go score. That's why you punt the football.
Waters complete to Lewis. A gain of 12, 1st and 10 from a Sooner 40.
Fullback, we play that better, Frank Blevins. Fullback draw, they scored on it a while ago. Waters back to throw. You know, he played quarterback at SMU. Throws the ball pretty good.
Derek Hill, the receiver here, Coach, and he overthrows Hill. He was a non-factor yesterday. Supposed to be a
get off the block, James Good, and get to the ball. There's the wheel route right there.
Pass complete.
But you all did a good job of containing Hill yesterday.
Well, that secondary had something to do with that right there. That's quarterback doing a good job of trying to get something out of nothing here. He's taking a loss if he'd gone outside. One-armed, I tell you what, we're playing one-armed with James Good. He can't do anything with his left arm.
And that's the end of the third quarter. Oklahoma ahead 21-10. More of Oklahoma football in a moment. Welcome back to Oklahoma football. The Sooners up 21-10. Fourth quarter action, Coach. 4th and 5, a big play.
Got Scott Garl, big play, Scott Garl, captain.
Third and five, take that back.
Now this is a fourth down. See, now it's fourth down.
Now it's fourth down.
We keep our defense out there in case they don't go for the field goal. Now they're going to go on fourth down instead of the field goal. They're going for the touchdown. Get him, great pressure. He throws the ball, intercepted to Kenny McMichael. Good return to Kenny here. Oskies the ball at the goal line, brings it down about 30-yard line.
If they scored there, it would have made it 21-17. Then you're really in for a dogfight.
Big play. Two big plays with secondary right here. Two big plays. Three guys that play in the secondary and never started before.
And something that probably gives the confidence boost to the entire defense, and especially the young secondary.
Sure. Here's pressure by Adrian Cooper. Get off that block, Adrian. It's a good play by Curtis Williams in pursuit. There's Adrian going to run him down, tackling for loss. So he forces it in there, and we get the interception. Good run here by McMichael. He's a wishbone quarterback in high school. Good player.
First and 10 from the 31 for the Sooners, up by 11 now, starting the fourth.
Don't turn the football over. Protect it, protect it.
Anthony Stafford with the ball.
Rodney, option play, down the boundary. Damon Stell.
Goes to Damon Stell.
Stell picks up seven, third and two. Perry. Oh, we fumbled the football. Perry got it back. I tell you, we were lucky. God, we were lucky there. Punt the football away. Good field. See, they're inside their 20, yet we put the ball on the ground to play before, and they had an opportunity to get it about our 25-yard line.
42-yard punt by
Game
Tom
of breaks,
Thompson.
I tell you. You've got to be sound. We cannot turn the ball over. Good pass rush right there. It's good play. Tom Backus, Adrian Cooper, two sophomore players.
And Arizona held on that play as well. It was declined. Third and 15 now.
Good play by Kenny McMichael. Tom Backus. Tom chasing the ball. Good. Play him more. Needs to play more. Chase the ball like that.
Brett Holly will kick.
Fourth and 14. Holly punts to Park.
We've got us great field position. Let's go score with this one. We fumble it, but we get it back right there. So we get the ball at midfield. Great position now. All right, we pick it up a little bit later. First,
did we turn the ball over?
Arizona 11.
No, a couple of incomplete passes, and we pick
it
up later.
Here's the interception right here. And that's a big play by Kevin Thompson.
At this point, coach, it's 21-10.
Sophomore from Houston, Texas.
7 minutes left in the ball game when this play occurs, and things are in pretty good shape at this point.
And we take this one in. I wondered what happened to play field position we had before, why we couldn't score with it, what happened. But I don't remember that series. And here's Kevin making a big play with their next possession. He's self-tacklization right there. So we've got great field position here. Jamel Holloway on the option play. Jumps up in the crack, uses quickness and speed.
Holloway gains 11.
Hand the ball off to Damon. Protects the ball, Damon.
Damon Stell to the 5-yard line.
Second and goal from the 5.
How about Jamel Holloway? Do something with it, Jamel. Good job, Damon Stell.
Another great decision by Holloway, and Stafford uses his great speed, coach, once again. He's made several plays like that during his career, hasn't he?
Yeah, he runs over the pylon there, so they call him touchdown. It's hard to see which way the ball went, but all official sees is the pylon being knocked over the back. Pitches the ball. It's a great job. Great job, Anthony, looking it all the way in. That's a touchdown.
Gary Bennett.
The ball in his belly went right over the...
And that makes it 28-10. There is no further scoring. The final score, Oklahoma, 28-10 after R.D. Lasher comes on, makes the conversion good, and the Sooners have their second consecutive win. 2-0 on the year. The Budweiser player of the game and OU sidelines when Oklahoma football continues. Player of the game.
Our Budweiser player of the game actually is a group of players, the defensive backfield, and Coach Bobby Proctor, you're the man who leads them. And what do you think about this group of young men?
Hey, I'm belated. You know, you'll see me smile very much. And it was a great day. Kids played great. We made some mistakes, you know, early. But, boy, just to, you know, hold a football team down like them and play a guy like them, Coach, which kept telling everybody it's going to be a tight fit. And they're good. They're in the USC and Nebraska class. And I was really proud. I think the first interception came with Jerry Parks from Houston, which was a great play. The second play came with Kenny Mack when we were in a man coverage down on the goal line and made a great play. I thought he might have scored one time. And the third interception came from Kevin Thompson. He's from Houston, which they had used the wheel route on us once before. We kept hauling wheel route, and he had an interception. And I thought he was going to score. Somebody said somebody tripped him up from the backside.
Is this like another dynasty like in 76 brewing here with a bunch of young guys that can really play?
If we win 11, I'll say yes. If we don't, I won't say, because this bunch is young, got a long ways to go. You know, we didn't have to play, but we played our four defensive backs most of the day, played a little bit of nickel, but they're all young. You know, I got one senior, two juniors, and seven freshmen.
Well, Coach Proctor, congratulations to you and the defensive backfield for being the Budweiser player of the game. Now, let's go to the OU sidelines feature for this week.
Yeah.
Coach, it was a big win for you, win number 150 during your tenure at Oklahoma, the most ever for an Oklahoma coach. You lead the Big 8 Conference in most wins ever. 150.
I tell you, the...
Hello, you there?
Yeah, I'm here. I was just thinking about Tom Osborne. See, they won last week. Tom and I were tied going into this year. We both had won 148 games. He had lost a few more, but we were the winningest coach in Big 8 Conference history, and of course, for both schools. No one, Nebraska's won more than that. Of course, we had the record in Oklahoma. And now Tom slipped one, and I would say the odds-on favorite, the guy that lasts the longest, Tom or me, that will be the guy that ends up with the record. Coach, number 151 would be a special one for you. USC, Oklahoma, that's really a classic matchup. Two different styles, two different philosophies. Address the USC game.
Well, they are a team that has arrived back at national prominence. They have been off for a couple of years. I wished I had them on my schedule in 85, 86, and 87. They're down years, but that's not the way things work sometimes. You got to play them where they fall, and obviously we're not as talented as teams we were those years, but we're still a good football team looking forward to finding out what type of football team we are, and SC presents that challenge for us because they've arrived back, and the reason why is Rodney Pete, their excellent quarterback. He has the ability and talents to make the big play in the passing game and the running game, and he will put tremendous pressure on our defense and our secondary, our front forcing unit and our secondary. I would rather play their style of offense than the Arizona style of offense because I don't like option offensive football teams. But at the same time, I think that SC will be the game that tells us where the Sooners are. Coach, congratulations. Good luck this week.
Thank you.
We'll see you next week on Oklahoma Football.
Oklahoma Football has been brought to you by Budweiser, Beechwood Ace for that clean, crisp taste. This Bud's for you. Clothing for Barry Switzer and Dean Blevins was provided by Harold, Oklahoma City, Norman, and Tulsa.